Today, we'll be reviewing the functionality of bricks in our bot builder. Having your bot builder organized can be helpful, and bricks will make that happen. So this video will be divided into three sections. First, we'll see what bricks are and how they work. Secondly, we'll see the different settings you can manage inside a brick. And lastly, we'll be looking at the different brick workarounds and templates, and how you can reuse them in your bot. Using bricks is a clean way for organizing your blocks in bigger groups to keep your canvas clean and functional. These bricks work like folders, where you store different blocks and flows so you can categorize them. While creating bricks, you have to keep in mind certain things. First of all, for bricks to work, you need to place the block that you intend to use in between the start of the brick, which is the starting message, and the exit of the brick, the output. If this is not done, the brick won't work. So there are various ways to create a brick. The first way is creating an empty brick from scratch and then adding the series of blocks inside. The second way consists of selecting already existing blocks in your bot and grouping them into a brick. The brick settings are very simple. Just click on the three dots and configure your brick. Here, we can name the brick and add a description. I recommend naming your bricks wisely as it can get a bit messy when you have saved a lot by the same name. Let's move into bricks, workarounds, and templates. To comprehend this, you have to understand that bricks are reusable. When you create a brick, you get the option to create a brick template from that specific brick. This way, you can use the same brick on other bots in your account. To import a brick template into a bot, type the name of the brick you're looking for and click on Import. Be aware of that there are two types of brick templates. First, we have the local bricks. These are the ones that you have modified and/or created on your own and just stay in your account. And the global bricks that are available for all Landbot users to use and learn from. Oh, and keep into account that if you edit a brick that was imported, it doesn't affect the other bricks, just the one you're editing. So, we've seen what are bricks and how they work. We've also seen how to filter bricks by their name and description, and the different workarounds and templates that you can reuse in your workspace. And that's an introduction to Landbot bricks.